Trnava, day 2. Totally different than day 1, since we had a storm front that passed us overnight, and that brought strong northwest to north wind, much colder temperatures, and very clean air with perfect visibility. That's not what the pilots here care about. They care about thermals, and this early in the morning they are simply not yet there. So you can see we have some clouds in the sky. Those are wave clouds. This wave looks like generated from the hills in the distance. Otherwise, sky looks really messy and turbulent. I guess that's why there's now a crane available there at the parking area, in case anyone needs it to retrieve their plane from top of the tree, for example, or something like that. So first aid is ready, which is very nice to see. This is now like 4 starts in the morning, and still tactics are much the same. Go high, far into the wind, possibly to the end of the runway and a bit to the left, since there's a down there behind that harvested field. So in this direction the hill is sloping downwards into the valley, and there's a chance that slope and those trees might generate enough of a wave that will help you stay in the air for 10 minutes. So this isn't yet any thermal soaring, it's more a dynamic soaring, or wave riding or something like that, but it's the only way to stay in the air. Still, start heights I guess are 150 meters and more. Haven't seen anyone go lower. I've seen some attempts of trying lower and returning to ground in a few minutes. So the previous group, no one did a full 10 minutes. And now let's see what this group will do. Seconds. Someone is even waiting on the start, starting behind the group. So that's a strategy to keep everyone in check about their heights. But now everyone is climbing. So you can maybe trade off 5 seconds on the start for 10 meters less to be the lowest on the start, but not sure if this is the proper strategy here. now. I guess the lowest one are 130 meters here close to me. But the rest, they're 150 or more, like 180 meters. And as far in upwind as the available power enables them to go. So I've heard some pilots have 6S setups ready here with over 1 kilowatt of power, and they prepared those setups exactly for the conditions like this, because these kind of conditions are quite frequent in Trnava. We are used to them, and lack of power here really kills you. So this guy now thinks he's in good air apparently. Let's see if that's true. I guess his problem is that he didn't reach far enough upwind, and now he has to find something downwind, or at least at the side. Trying those trees there, but I think it's too early in the morning and the sun is not yet at the proper angle. You see how bumpy the air is, but looks like he got something now. Yeah, this looks good. Another one joined him from the above. Four planes now over there, and the thing is, this kind of thermal might enable you to stay in the air, but you will be blown so far downwind in the process that you won't be able to return, and you kind of have to return. I see another shadow crossing me, so it means more planes are now on the way towards the corridor, trying their luck somewhere down there or getting ready to land. getting a good score for landing in these less than 10-minute flights is worth more than on your typical 10-minute flight. So I guess it makes sense to prioritize a good landing. One more. I guess that's it. Oh no, there's one more. Minutes to go, and I think he's the last one landing. So much like in the previous group, 8-minute flight was the maximum achievable. Extra. Looks like there's a group of people looking for, I'm hoping not a plane, but it's the only explanation why they would be there. So looks like some planes are already in need of that crane. Unpleasant. Day 2, afternoon, about 1:30. This is around 5, group 7 I believe. And if you look at the water towers there at the nuclear power plant, you get an idea of the wind speed. So everyone's flying with their planes loaded with maximum ballast far into the wind. There really is no other way, so you have to find a wave somewhere up front and ride it back home. So some groups manage to find something on the left side, some other groups manage to find something on the right side, so it's not really clear. Now I see someone doing something new in this group. He stayed back about at the corridor, but with to the right, and he's trying downwind. Let's see if I can zoom in on him. He is much higher than the rest of the people up front, but in his position it's easier to see when he's in good air. So it would be really interesting to see if this strategy works out for him. Wind is still strong. We have a storm system passing us a few kilometers to the south. That's why we have such nice clouds. Nice and dramatic. But fortunately, no rain. So far we were lucky with the rain. It was always arriving at 8 p.m. or later, when the flying was already done. So we can use full day to do the qualifying rounds. So this guy so far didn't do much, just staying there, losing height at about the same rate as everybody else. And since he was higher from the start, he is still the highest, I believe, because we already have people, planes here close to the ground. And these two guys can do maybe two or three circles and then land. Nothing else for them to do. I don't believe they can gain height this way, maybe additional 30 seconds or so. One is coming back asking for a refly. And the other one as well. That guy there is climbing. Congratulations. He's now also giving up and flying back to the landing points. And he maybe found there something too? No? Just going to land. And this is 5 minutes to go. Situation in the air. Couple of planes that were high enough to cross the runway to the right side still have pretty decent height, and I guess they can make it till the end. Interesting question is, these two guys at the bottom, are they high enough to also make it or not? So one is trying forward, other is trying over the corridor, now also following him. I guess they are looking for a beginning of that thermal. This one looks like he found it. Congratulations. The other one a bit behind is not so successful. It's now joining him. Decided to land apparently. So he also decided not to go further downwind and is now trying to do the same exercise again, maybe a few more turns before going for landing. Air looks good here. Also went for a safe choice. Okay, and there's one keeping position in the middle of the runway and keeping height as well. I can't judge from this point how much distance he's gaining downwind, but looks like he's able to come back just fine. Looks like five planes made this full round. Which is more than the previous round. Okay, great. Today and tomorrow will certainly add more differences in the top 14 pilots in the scoring, and it won't be just a few percent separating the top pilots, but much more, I hope. Some impressions of flight from the flight line. People in the ready box. official weather display. Shows 5.5 meters per second of gust wind speed, so not too much, and looks like the competition is perfectly regular.
Alleen niet.
To je 11, 12. Dobre, už tam idú.
Ah. Tak, ale to
even some offsets. Oops. Lots of mice holes on the ground.
Jaz sem ti povedal, ko sem ugotovil, da le ne gledaš pravi avio.
It's now nearly 6 p.m. Skies have cleared up. We have sun. And we still have wind. This is now round 7 with the seniors already. Group 2, I believe. And the flying strategy is still much the same. Planes loaded up with ballast, flying far into the wind, hoping for a piece of good air that would allow them to stay in the air for full 10 minutes. So what I see now is the birds now playing over there. And they just have fun. But it looks like none of the pilots decided to explore what kind of air they have fun in. As far as I can see, there's only one relatively close to them. That guy here somewhere. I think he's also the lowest of this group. Then there are two more planes exploring the air that should be downwind from where the birds were playing. There. Then there are two more up here near the edge of the cornfield, just hanging there. Now the lower one has started to do some turns. Has not stopped again, so I think he's losing height rather fast and has to do something about it. only thing he can do is fly home. It looks like the planes from the western side of the field are also almost home already. Here down, further downwind. Then I saw someone trying to get some good air over the trees there. Turns out there are two planes and both of them are also returning to their landing points. Nothing much there either. About it. So maybe a word on the interesting design of that horizontal tail. It's some new fashion item I see in some of the explorers this year. Looks like they're trying to change or improve the behavior of the horizontal tail in circling. Don't know if that really helps them, but for me this makes all the planes really distinctive in the air. So once I learn which pilots are flying them, I hope I'll be able to recognize them in the air. Admit this guy is fighting for time very effectively. Not losing height at all, not moving much at all, just hanging there. Okay, now he lost a bit. I would guess this is a wave coming from the tree line. He's just hanging there. Riding that wave. decided now he has enough of that. And he's flying home. Could be that this is Arjan Huceljuk. I need to check. Certainly he's the last one to land in this group. The other pilots already packed their plane and are leaving the corridor. And the time on the clock says what? 10 seconds to go. Almost a full time for that Explorer pilot. And this time of day, it's good result.